So the voyage left Wellington and we tracked down the east coast past a big pod of dusky dolphins along the way that put on a bit of a show for us. And then we carried on all the way down to the Auckland Islands. And that's where we did our demersal trawl survey and started our DTIS camera work. And from there, we then worked our way up to Stewart Island and we surveyed some of the shelf and slope around the Stewart snares as well, which was a different sort of experience because we're really close to the island there and we could... I've never been to Stewart Island, so I got a good view and decided I wanted to go back. New Zealand sea lions at the Auckland Islands at least show a number of classic indicators of food limitation, and so this survey was all about describing the spatial and depth distribution of known sea lion prey species to evaluate how hard sea lions are having to work to eat each of these things. And we used a number of different methods for doing that. So we used the demersal trawl survey because that's a good catcher of lots of known sea lion prey. We used DTIS camera work, which was useful for identifying different kinds of habitat that are used by sea lions and some of the things that aren't caught by the trawl survey. And also the octopus potting, which didn't work quite so well. In fact, we only caught one, but that escaped from the gear just as we were hauling it up onto deck. And there was a sea lion sat on the surface watching that. So maybe we might have helped the sea lions in some small way with that survey.
So I just can visualize that.
I think they will eat anything that fits in their mouth in the areas that they like to forage. And the exceptions of that are the spiny things or the things that have really rough exoskeletons. One of the more interesting outcomes of the survey was that we caught quite a lot of southern blue whiting. And we know from surveys going back to the late 70s that didn't really used to appear in the survey. In survey stations around the Auckland Islands. And it's only since about 2005 or 2006 that we've seen that. And in the latest survey, in the survey that we just did, it turned out to have the highest biomass estimate of any species. So things are changing around the Auckland Islands and we don't understand what causes all of those changes. And that's be one of the tasks for us to understand why they occur.